Hello and welcome back to the final area of Dark Vision 10 on Global Server. I don't have anything to say about Anima. Debuff her so much. We'll talk about it later. Let's start with the first stage in this area. So this stage is a physical domain of Wind and Light. Boss is a human-type monster. For this stage, I try my best to figure out the budget team, but it doesn't work. My Tifa able to deal around 1 billion damage. You need a lot of support here, and I'm too lazy for that, so I use that will leg, and you don't need them, but having them make your life a lot easier with this stage. You need to have 100% resistance after buff for dark and earth element. If you don't have that, you're able to use a magic cover tank. So magic cover tank will cover all earth element damage, so you need only dark element. Shoreline Fina and Daisy is the best here because she able to be a magic cover tank, or she able to be a buffer because she has a cooldown that able to provide 100% resistance on earth and dark. Alright, let's start with the first unit. Mastermind will be a physical evasion and provoke tank. As usual, you don't need this much gear because this is a gear for Anima, but I used him in this stage before. You need to focus on evasion and provoke, that all he needs on Mastermind. Vaan will be a breaker and he will chain AR with Mastermind. The only thing he needs is dual wielding. You don't need elemental weapon because Shoreline Fina and Daisy will imbue light to them. Faithy will be a magic cover tank. As I said, if you don't use her as cover tank, you're still able to use her as a buffer. She has 100% earth and dark resistance. But if you use her as a magic cover tank, you need 100% or more after buff for earth resistance. And don't look at those gear because I tried so many strategies but it doesn't work. So we go back to the normal one. Starlight Illina will be a human killer buffer and skill finisher. Not only that, she's gonna do 130% light imperil. We're not gonna use her in this form, so you don't need to gear her. On her bare form, focus on physical human killer and her attack. Having her magic is very good, but you don't need to focus on that. Just gear her for attack as much as possible. Tifa will be a limit burst finisher, and because this is 3 turn kill, you don't even need to worry that much about her limit fill. So on normal form, she can have anything that speed up her limit fill. On her bare form, gear her for a human killer limit burst damage and her attack. So she has 300% on human killer and limit burst damage. Latwell and Legend will be another limit burst finisher. This is a unit that you need to focus on fill limit gauge. But having 2 turn to fill that, I think it is enough. If it is not enough, I slot in Call of the Wild to make it faster. On their bare form, gear them for a human killer limit burst damage and their attack. So with this build, they have 300% human killer and limit burst damage boost. Okay, that's all for the gear. Let's go. Another thing that I forget to mention, you don't need any status protection. Boss don't have any status attack. Alright, because we're gonna do 3 turn kill, we have a lot of free turn here. Let's start with one. Let's use Jet Parry. For Shoreline Fina and Daisy, let's use her cover and Lagoon Shell for 100% earth and dark resistance. For Laswell Legend, we need to fill their limit burst as fast as possible. So we need to use their eye attack 3 times to fill their limit gauge. Starlight Illina will triple cast here, Lock Over 4 to imbue herself and increase elemental attack, and use 2 of her cooldown. So one of her cooldown is decreased light resistance for 130%. Mastermind and Tifa are able to do anything, so don't worry that much about fill Tifa limit gauge. Okay, on the second turn, let's start with Cholai, Fina, and Daisy. And we need to do a healing ripple to fill Tifa limit gauge. And extra special sunbath for a light imbue. Shift Elena to her breath form. And use triple cast. We're gonna use her light attack again for a elemental buff. I think this have a better number on her breath form. And her Magnus ability for 200% human killer buff. Fan use his limit burst to break 85%. Lazio and Legan use let's see. We're not gonna use his amplifying because we not use fire or ice attack. Let's use complete awakening to buff his attack and limit burst damage. I think the only one is enough. Because we already feel his limit gauge. Alright, shift Tifa to her best form and use Awaken Fighting Spirit. Mastermind will copy all of that, so critical on Elena and critical on Last Will Legan. For real, you don't need to copy Last Will Legan's attack because Elena also has 300% attack buff on herself. Okay, we can ignore all those attacks with Elemental Resistance. As you can see here, I did not use Fazy to do a magic cover. But we still don't take any single damage. Okay, for the kill turn. Start with Starlight Elena. Let's use her triple cast. So use her cooldown first and two of her finishing moves. Last will again use his limit burst. I forget to shift to breath form, okay? Tifa also use her limit burst. Mastermind Sword and Wand dual cast their AR chaining move. And guard Fazy. Okay, send AR first. After that, send Elena. Wait for 30 chain, send Tifa and Lazio Legend. Lazio Legend is replaceable if you don't have the. It can be any finisher here. Alright. That for the first stage in this area. Move to the magical stage. On the second stage in this area, this is a magical domain of ice and dark. Bot is spirit type monster. For real in this stage, it's not that hard, especially if you have Ibarra in your team. Ibarra is very good here because she has a direct element, which is dark element, and she also has 150% spirit killer in her kit. I put King Resist here because I forget that she has 150% in her kit. So I think that we need 75% fairy killer from Regis, but I digress. Okay, let's start with the first unit. Regis will be a physical evasion and provoke tank. On the first thing that I want him to be is he will provide a 75% fairy killer, but we don't want that anymore. You can replace him with Mastermind Sword so they have AR chaining move. One will be a breaker and AR chainer. So the only thing you need is dual wielding equipment. Yoshihiri will be a limit burst buffer. Yes, because we use Ibarra that she don't have any sort of limit burst damage buff. You need to have Yoshihiri in your team too. Not only that, he will attack bot with ice element. Ibarra will be a limit burst finisher, so we don't need to care that much about her limit fill because she already fulfilled her limit burst gauge at the very beginning of the battle. On her breath form, gear her for a spirit killer, limit burst damage, and her magic. With this build, she had 275 spirit killer and 300% limit burst damage. You will see a lot of physical gear on her equipment. Yes, she loves physical gear more than mage gear. Start with Fan, use his limit burst to break. Regis will triple cast on his cooldown. Marie will use her cooldown excessive lover for a 100% elemental resistance buff. Yoshi dual cast his 2 cooldown. And Iba shift to her breath form. We gonna triple cast here because we need to attack with weak element. So start with her cooldown weakening appear. And we gonna buff her spirit killer with Isayoi. So this skill has 150% fairy killer. And the final one is Angoku. Okay, for the kill turn. Before we doing that, we need to attack board with weak element. Start with Marie, use dual cast with Sard. Yoshikiri shift to his breath form. We gonna triple cast again this time. First, use Nijutsu Kaiho for 150% limit burst damage and 2 ice score. We just use dual cast his AR chaining move. One also use Lucent Glare from Regis. And Ibara use her limit burst. Send everybody together. Wow, that 2.5 billion damage with Ibara alone. She is very powerful. She is I think she is 3 months old by now, but her power is still very very good at this day. Okay, that is for the magical set.